One of Glasgow's oldest pubs, which is links to Frank Sinatra and Laurel and Hardy and an Italian restaurant institution, are preparing to say a final farewell to customers after a 148-year history in the city. The Iron Horse, which dates from 1872, and O Sole Mio, Glasgow's oldest surviving Italian restaurant, which opened in 1965, will close their doors for the last time within the first few days of February, when their leases expire. The pub and restaurant are among five businesses on the corner of West Nile Street and Bath Street closing as plans progress for a new £30 million multi-storey hotel. Jennifer Brooks, who runs the Iron Horse and Djamel Benouari, spoke of their sadness at the loss of their livelihoods and two Glasgow institutions. Read more: Glasgow pub, chippy, an Italian institution facing demolition to make way for hotel. The Iron Horse was previously known as the Empire Bar, which served the theatre-goers and stars of the famous theatre of the same name around the corner. For the past few decades it has served as a city centre local for Glaswegians and meeting point for the Tartan Army. In its 55-year history, O Sole Mio has been a popular haunt for celebrities including Billy Connolly and Old Firm footballers. Former Rangers and AC Milan player Gennaro Gattuso, now managing Napoli, met his wife Monica Romano in the restaurant, while Lorenzo Amoruso was also a regular. George Capital, which now owns the block, is seeking permission to flatten the site, on the corner of West Nile Street and Bath Street, to make way for a hotel, that the developers say will create 100 new jobs. Djamel, 62, said, "We knew it was coming because the lease had not been renewed. But when the shutters come down, I'll be sad. The miracle I was hoping for didn't come." More than 400 objections to the plan were lodged with the council, while a petition created by the Iron Horse attracted more than 2,000 signatures, with objections coming from as far as Azerbaijan and the US. According to a council spokesman, the hotel application is working its way through the planning process. Read more: developer granted permission to demolish Trongate building. The Blue Lagoon fish and chip shop will also shut, as well as a small beauty business and betting shop. Paddy Power is already boarded up. Jennifer Brooks took over the running of the Iron Horse in the 1990s with her father Reddy. The former Empire Bar became the Iron Horse in the 1960s, and after a couple of name changes in the 70s and 80s the pub reopened with the existing name. Jennifer said the family is focused on helping the venue's 12 staff find other jobs, while a Tartan Army farewell party is planned in the final weekend on February 1st and 2nd. Jennifer said, "I've had elderly customers who say they saw Frank Sinatra in the Empire. For more on this story, visit the news article link."